I just watched one of the greatest upsets in professional wrestling. Ron Ritchie, Eddie Watts, defeating the Cuban Commandos. But there's a little in the background here. There's a little misunderstanding. And my goodness, what are we looking at?
You know what? We don't need the Weasel. We don't need the Six Brothers, because we're ready to take the Six Brothers right in this ring or any place around the world or in Canada or whatever. And we're going to put that belt around our waist, because that belt was belonged to the Cuban Commando before that. And it's they, a pair of yellow cowards, that attack us from behind, and then they run. Everybody see they run, but next time or next week, no place to hide and no place to run.
Jerry Moore, are we looking towards a championship match with the Sings after this?
First of all, Mr. Bulldog Bourbon, the manager, we don't need that. We come for the commando. We tough. We know what the ball is about. Do you hear me? Listen, Makasin and Vulcan Singh, what you have between you and your waist, that will belong to us. Now, Maka, you used to be my partner. I know all you tweet. All you tweet, I know about it. I have some new one you don't know about it.
You're gonna be a well. Well, meat to support and to feed the animal over here in the zoo.
What a match would that be? A Sings against the Commandos? Wow. We'll be right back. Here's Ed Whalen.
Ah, little dissension in the Karachi Vice ranks.
There's no dissension at all, Whalen. Their history, we can't tolerate ignorance or idiots, and they fit into both of them categories. They don't touch the Weasel. They never come after Abu Weasel. He took us to the top of the wrestling world, and we're still in the top of the wrestling world. Maybe they're jealous, Whalen. You know, there's no room for jealousy in this business, in the world. We beat the British Bulldogs. The British Bulldogs beat them. So maybe they figure that's the only way they can get another title shot is take a shortcut and attack our manager, Abu Weasel. They want to rant and rave and they want to fire the Weasel. Well, I'll tell you what, it was already in the works in the Karachi Vice. Volk and I, Abu Weasel, we had sat down. It was time to get rid of the riffraff. One Fidel Castro lookalike, one refugee from the Martinique Navy used to paddle around in a canoe. Well, I'll tell you something, you banana-eating, coconut-piling thing, right. Moro, and Cuban assassin, you want to get in the wrestling ring, right, with Vulcan and I, you get ready, because we don't care who it is. You want to be the two heroes, you come in, and I hope you got
it's
some padding.
Line
shut up, Whalen. I hope you got some padding underneath those little G.I. Joe pants, because we're going to beat
what
them right
think?
Off you.
What do you think?
My brother Mucka just said the reason why they did this to the Weasels because of jealousy, because we're the greatest tag team in the world. We've beaten the British Bulldogs. We'll be beating Benoit and Wellington, anybody. They want to try and get a shot at our title belts through our manager. They got it. If they want it, bring it on.
All right. I don't want
to eat too many bean burritos, Cuban, because if you bend over with gas, you might
fall. Just forget it. I don't want to talk to you.